Hello and welcome to One and All. I'm Jagath and welcome back to my channel. And today in this video, we are going to see about the camera comparison between 10G and the MA1. So I have actually taken many photos and videos with both these devices in various conditions like indoor, outdoor and low light photos. So let's have a look at them one by one. Okay guys, before getting started, let's just have a quick camera specification of these devices. MA1 has a dual camera setup with dual 12 megapixel sensors with an aperture of f2.2. 10G has a 13 megapixel sensor on both the lenses with an aperture of 2.0. Coming to the camera place, moving on to the front camera, MA1 has a 5 megapixel sensor placed on the left hand side. 10G has its camera placed on the right hand side, which is a 16 megapixel sensor, and on the left hand side it has an LED flashlight. Okay guys, now moving on to the photos taken in outdoor conditions. So in outdoor conditions, basically 10G photos were actually brighter and also had much more details to it compared to the MA1. As you all can see, the leaves are greener in the photo taken in 10G compared to the MA1. Okay guys, now moving on to the indoor shots. In indoor, photos taken in both these devices were actually similar to each other. In HDR mode, as we all can see, MA1 photos are actually better than 10G. So this is the comparison between normal mode and HDR mode. Now moving on to the bokeh mode. The first thing which I noticed is that 10G takes a bit of time for processing the bokeh shots. The second thing which I noticed is that MA1 actually blurs the background better than 10G. MA1 photos taken in bokeh mode are actually little bit zoomed in. This is because of the vertical camera setup which I already spoke at the start of the video. Then moving on to the next thing is that some photos in both these devices actually didn't blur the background, or the objects itself got blurred. MA1 really struggled to capture good photos at low light conditions. Now moving on to the low light photos. Okay guys, just remember that 10G has a 16 megapixel sensor on the front side, whereas MA1 has only 5 megapixel sensor. 10G also has an LED flashlight even on the front side, which makes it very useful even in low light conditions. So as we all can see, even the background objects are clear in 10G. Now coming to the overall photo quality. These devices had their positives and negatives, but one thing which I didn't like is the blue shade which occurred in 10G. I'll be actually revealing the exact reason why the bluish shade occurred in 10G in later part of this video, so make sure to watch this video fully. Now let's move on to the video. Again, in videos also I got that bluish shade in 10G. As you all can see, both the videos look similar to each other. There is no big difference in both these devices. Now moving on to the outdoor conditions. Remember guys, both MA1 and 10G does not have optical image stabilization, but 10G has image stabilization. But in this recording I have not turned it on. So basically whatever we are watching right now is the raw footage.
The right side I have the MA1 and left side I have the 10G.
Thank you.
Okay guys, on my right side I have the MIA1 and on my left side I have the 10RG. So the time is basically now 5:45 in the evening. So this is the video quality in the evening time. I have not attached any external mic. So if you are getting some wind noise, I'm really sorry for it. So basically this video I'm recording with the front cam. I'm just walking around with the phones in my hand. So okay guys, that's the quality.
Okay guys, this is in night time. So basically as we all can see, in 10RG the video is little bit brighter than MIA1, but again in some part of the video I got that bluish shade in 10RG.
On my right side I have the MIA1 and on my left side I have the 10RG. So this is basically the low light test. So let's now walk and see the quality of it. So as you all can see, still I am able to recognize my face in the 10RG, whereas in MIA1, I am not able to get my face, whereas in 10RG, there is some light on my face. So as you all can see, okay guys, now I have turned on the flash in my 10RG and there is no flashlight in front facing camera of MIA1. So now let's test the quality. So basically as you all can see, with the light coming from 10RG, even in MIA1 I'm able to get my face clearly. So this flash is really powerful. So as you all can see guys, as I have turned on my light in 10RG, I am able to get my face in MIA1 also. So basically this is the quality.
Okay, now let's check the image stabilization in 10RG. So as we all can see, with image stabilization on, the video is smoother. In MIA1 we can shoot time lapse and slow motion, whereas in 10RG we cannot. In earlier part of the video I actually mentioned that we get that bluish shade in photos and videos taken using 10RG. Okay, the main reason for that is 10RG camera is little bit slower. MIA1 actually adapts to the lightning conditions pretty quickly, whereas 10RG takes some time. So this is the main reason for it. Okay guys, that's pretty much it from this video. Hope you all find this video useful. If you all have not yet subscribed my channel, please make sure to hit that subscribe button. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for more.